पिछले श्लोक में खास बात यही आई थी कि जो हमारे पास जो कैपेसिटी है नॉलेज की, उस नॉलेज की कैपेसिटी से ही हम जो है अपने आप को जान सकते हैं, नोइंग द सेल्फ, ये बात पीछे कही थी कल आई। अब अगली बात कह रहे हैं, श्लोक है चरित दंशनम नानम नवीनानम न चरितम न दंशनम जान गो शुद्धो। इसका इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन है द ट्राइफर्केशन ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस इंटू कंडक्ट वर्ल्ड व्यू एंड नॉलेज चरित्र दर्शन और ज्ञान possessed by the cognizer is only an empirical conception. Transcendentally, there is no knowledge, no conduct, no worldview, just pure consciousness.
Everything else is gone. By itself,
the purest form of soul.
That is the. But the author is so bold to say such thing. Boldly he asserts, pure consciousness is pure consciousness and nothing else. Annotation by Jethabhai. This verse introduces the unique technique called naya, conceived by the Jain scholars for comprehending a very complex entity like soul or jiva. When we are dealing with a complex entity which possesses innumerable attributes, some of which are empirical, that is useful in worldly life, while some others are purely transcendental and incapable of being apprehended by normal human faculties. It is impossible to grasp its nature in its entirety at once. This is the problem, because the soul itself has infinite number of attributes and we want to know soul through the attributes. How can we know the soul? This is the only means is, if we know all the attributes of the soul, we can know the soul. So here comes the difficulty. So it is clearly stated that then only the naya is a tool we have got, through which we can go and probe into the nature of reality. That is naya. It is the technique for comprehending such a complex subject. By studying only a part of it at a time. Now what naya gives the facility to us? What it facilitates? Naya gives us facility to know one quality at one time. Although our objective, aim, is to know infinite qualities, unless we know, how can we know the whole thing? But the naya gives us this facility that I will give you the knowledge of one quality at one time. Now, if you know the Heisenberg principle, uncertainty principle, for which Heisenberg was given the Nobel Prize, what he states in uncertainty principle, which is the basic principle of modern physics, quantum theory, etc., atomic theory, etc. Werner Heisenberg, he was given the Nobel Prize, and he gave this theory, this principle, which is called as uncertainty principle. Now you know, he talks about science. One of the greatest scientists. And science swears or claims whatever we speak about is certain. And he says, uncertainty principle. And he is given Nobel Prize.
Also a scientist.
Nobel Prize, but he came
for uncertainty principle.
Principle of uncertainty.
Uncertainty principle, he is saying, that you want to study electron completely at one time. You want to know all the properties of electron. Because electron is the unit through which the whole world is explained in physics. It's the basic unit, electron.
Yeah, yeah.
So unless we know everything about electron at the same time, we cannot know everything about other things. Then he probed into the activities of electron and he came to the conclusion it is impossible to know the momentum and the position of the electron at the same time.
Changes. Changes.
This is uncertainty principle.
આપણે કહીએ છીએ ને, આપણે ઠંડીમાં ઉભા હોય સૂર્ય તપતો હોય તો ગરમીનો અનુભવ કરીએ તો ઠંડીનો નહીં કરતા, ઠંડીનો કરીએ તો ગરમીનો નહીં કરતા. ઉપયોગ એક જ કહે
અને નયથી દરેક ઉપયોગને સમજવાના અને પછી આપણે આખું નોલેજને ભેગું કરવું.
Such a complex subject by studying only a part of it at a time without discarding the other part. Nay says, we are not discarding the other part. But for our facility, our convenience, what we do not consider now other parts at the same time. As Heisenberg said, if you want to know about the velocity, momentum, I can tell you exactly, precisely. But you ask me one question only. You don't ask me that what is the velocity and what is its position. I can't answer both the questions at the time, simultaneously. Then that was made clear in how he explained one this thing.
That's your issue.
So noise is a technique of comprehending such a complex subject by studying only a part, one part of it at a time without discarding other parts. Just like a branch of science that deals with some particular aspect of things, leaving others on one side. The various sciences are different not because they deal with different things or different sets of facts, but because they look at these facts from different aspects to deal with different objects. The same object, hydrogen is studied by physics, hydrogen is studied by chemistry. But physics studies hydrogen from another point of view. Chemistry studies hydrogen from another point of view. And all these together makes it a scientific view.
Similarly, Atma cannot be studied all attributes together.
Yes.
One at a time.
Okay.
Thus physics is concerned with mass, density, temperature and such other aspects or parameters of physical objects. Chemistry on the other hand studies how they are constituted. For example, two atoms of hydrogen combined with one atom of oxygen to produce one molecule of water and leaves the above aspect aside. So in this same way, the thing is to be understood.
આનો સ્વીકાર કરીએ ને તો આ બધું ઓટોમેટિક થાય છે, ખબર પડે સંજોગોના દબાણથી થાય. બે ભાગ હાઇડ્રોજન એક ભાગ ઓક્સિજન ભેગો થાય, પાણી થાય તો પાણી બનાવે.
કુદરત એનું ઇમ્પોર્ટન્સ બતાવીશ.
આપણે આ શું છે, નય નિક્ષેપા ભૂલી જ ગયા, જૈનોની ડિક્શનરીમાંથી નીકળી ગયા, શું
એમને લીધે જ બધી ગરબડતાણ એમાં.
અને જીવત તો આ હારા ખોટામાં પડત જ
સમય થયા.
હવે બે નય મુખ્ય રૂપમાં નિશ્ચય અને
પહેલા વાત,
ઓલ ધ ટેકનિક્સ ઓફ એપ્રિહેન્ડિંગ ધ સોલ કેન બી બ્રોડલી બ્રોટ અંડર ટુ ગ્રુપ્સ. One, Vyavahar. Second, Nishchay. Vyavahar nay or empirical technique deals mainly with the attributes which are useful in actual worldly life and presents them so that they can be understood by common people. It usually leaves all ultimate questions aside. The empirical standpoint or viewpoint, Vyavahar na, its domain is only that attributes, that characteristic, that properties which come in our daily use, worldly use. It, the domain is this, that's all. It cannot go beyond that domain.
आपने मुनिश्री एग्जाम्पल दिया है इल्यूमिनेटर ऑफ जैना किंगर्स में, भवरे का रंग काला है, ये व्यवहार न्याय है, लेकिन निश्चय न्याय में उसके सातों कलर है, निश्चय न्याय में उसके पांचों कलर
है. मतलब ना आप देखो जो ना कि आ डोमेन व्यवहारिक जीवन में, बट देट अगेन आपने जो नॉलेज गेन करो जो एज लिमिट में आ जाए अत्यार सुधी में વિથ ધીસ લાઈફની અંદર જે બી આપણે નિશ્ચયનું તો કંઈ જ નથી આવતું ને એમાં. હવે એ સમજી અને પછી આ વ્યવહારને સમજવાની કોશિશ કરવી પડે.
વ્યવહાર એટલે સંજોગ. આપણે બધું બહારનું સરાઉન્ડિંગનું જ્ઞાન કર્યું છે,
કારણ કે આપણે લિમિટેશન એમાં છે.
Deals mainly with attributes advantage. It is necessarily an analytic process breaking down complex features into simple ones. Vyavahar nahi, what is the work of Vyavahar nahi? What it wants to do? There is a complex thing. It breaks down that into simple things so that you can understand. So that is called analytic approach. Vyavarna is analytic approach. Isko isi bhi kehte hain bhed pradhan. Bhed pradhan. Go on analysis, more and more, divide. So this is called analytic approach.
Ashram dhatsunu jvadan kalema.
Okay.
Now, now, on the other hand, Nishchayana is concerned mainly with ultimate problems of existence and presents the transcendental aspects of Jiva or soul. Its approach is synthetic rather than analytic. Now when we want to know something about soul, about the self, through nishchayana, then we will have to put away the spectacles of Vyavarna, that is analytic approach, and put the spectacles of Nishchayana, that is synthetic approach. Thus, the fundamental characteristic of soul is consciousness. Fundamental characteristic of soul is consciousness. And material, only one, consciousness. Vyavaharna breaks down this attribute into three simpler elements. It is one, consciousness, transcendentally. But in Vyavahar, worldly aspect, it is divided into three parts. Conduct, worldview, and knowledge. Ultimately, however, all the three are put together to make up a complex whole. The verse emphasizes that the breakdown of the whole into three elements is useful only in the worldly life. So here in this verse, the author wants to emphasize the breakdown of the whole in three elements, which is useful in worldly life. An emancipated soul does not lose consciousness, because it is the characteristic which never leaves Jīva. But there is no necessity there of the analytic process, since the soul has transcended all the divisions. Understood?
Yeah.
Now, here we had discussed one day, I was going through the proof of Bhagavati Sutra.
Right.
Bhagavati Sutra. And when I came across one thing, I was saying, how is it so? There was a question there, whether Virya Atma exists in Siddha or not. There are eight Atmas considered in our empirical view.
Yeah.
Transcendental view, there is one Atma only, that is
dravya.
Okay? Yeah. Now, other Atmas are there. Jnana Atma, Upyoga Atma, Charitra Atma, Virya Atma, all these Dharma. So, I had, before reading that text actually, I had in my mind that Virya Atma exists in Siddha. Why? Because Antaraya Karma, that is the obstructing karma, antaraya. It is completely annihilated, kshaya. Therefore, Virya Atma must be there. Anant Virya, Anant Sakti. Where will it go? It is in the Atma, just as the Jnana is there. So that is all my
point of view,
my preconception about Siddha Atma. But when I read that Bhagavati Sutra, it was given there that in Siddha Atma there is no Virya. It is avirya. Then again, very wide description is given. In 14th Gunasthan, what happens? Gautam Swami go away to asking them, what about 14th Gunasthan? 14th Gunasthan, there is Ayog.
Ayogi Kevri.
So there is Virya there or not? What is the answer? There is Virya from the point of view of Labdhi. Labdhi Virya. It is there, but no Karana Virya. And in Siddha, it is totally avirya.
No Virya. એ આત્માને કર્મથી દૂર કરવા માટે જે શક્તિ વપરાતી હતી એ લબ્ધિ વીર્ય, પણ પછી એની જરૂર જ નથી. ઇટ ઇઝ નોટ ધેર.
એટલે સીધું આપણે બોલીએ આનંદ જ્ઞાન આનંદ દર્શન
ખાલી બસ જ્ઞાન દર્શન સમજુઓ બસ
હરિહંદની વાત કે
કેવલ જ્ઞાની તીર્થંકર સહયોગી He utilizes the virya. Therefore, it is savirya. Therefore, it is using the anant shakti of atma and using man, vachan, kaya, ka yog. But in 14 gunasthan, it becomes lakti, ayogi. Lakti virya is there, but current virya is not there. And in siddha avastha, emancipated soul, there is no virya more.
Why no virya?
Why? Because virya now, has no use, no utility, just like charitra. There is no charitra in siddha. Charitra atma does not exist in siddha.
Charitra na to virya ni jarurat nahi ne.
Charitra atma does not exist in siddha.
એટલે કારણા નથી બહુ સમજવું પડે. આ કારણ કહેવાય. આ નથી દેખાય તો કે આના વગર દેખાય તો કે ના નથી છે તો દેખાય.
ઉપયોગ
આપવા
ઉપયોગ હે જ્ઞાન હે દર્શન હે દ્રવ્ય તો હે
દર્શન હે દ્રવ્ય
બચ્ચા
આપણે જેમ કે પેલું સમય સમય વિચારે છે કે એક સમય જાણે એક સમય દેખે જ્યારે દિગંબરો એટ એ ટાઈમ જ્ઞાન દર્શન હોય એવું કહે છે તમે શું માનો
એમ એમાં કહ્યું છે સાપેક્ષ સ્થિતિમાં કે આત્માનો સ્વભાવ જે છે જ્ઞાનની પર્યાય અને દર્શનની પર્યાય બંને છે એ આપણના સ્વભાવમાં છે જ્ઞાન દર્શન એ કંઈ એટલા માટે નથી કે જાણે છે કે બીજી વસ્તુ જે છે એમાં સામાન્ય વિશેષ છે એવું નથી આત્માના સ્વભાવમાં જે ઉપયોગ આત્મા જે છે એ સાકાર અને નાકાર ઉપયોગ એ બંને એક સાથે હંમેશા એ બંને પર્યાયો એ જ્ઞાનની ઉપયોગની હંમેશા હોય છે એટલે બંને હોય છે હવે આપણે વ્યવહારમાં કેવી રીતે સમજી શકીએ આપણી પાસે એનું કંઈ છે નહીં એટલા માટે આપણે શું કહીશું એમાં કે કેવળ જ્ઞાન અને કેવળ દર્શન એ પ્રમાણે એનો ઉપયોગ એ પ્રમાણે આપણે વ્યવહારની દ્રષ્ટિએ આપણે કહી શકીએ ખાલી ખાલી બાકી નિશ્ચયમાં તો બને એક જ છે એક જ પર્યાય છે એક જ ઉપયોગ આત્મા એક જ છે એની જ પર્યાય છે બંને અને હંમેશા બંને રહે છે પણ એ પ્રોસેસ આપણે માટે જે છે આપણો જે પ્રોસેસ જ્ઞાન દર્શનનો અને સમજવાનો એ જુદો છે અને ટ્રાન્સેન્ડ નિશ્ચય ને એનો છે એ જુદો
ના ને સિદ્ધાત્મામાં વાત આવે
ઉપયોગ આવે તો
એટ અ ટાઈમ આવે છે જ્ઞાન દર્શન
સિદ્ધાત્મામાં
સિદ્ધાત્મામાં એક સમય જાણે એક સમય દેખે બોલીએ છીએ
ઉપયોગ
સિદ્ધમાં ને
ના પણ આપણે સિદ્ધમાં એવું માનીએ છીએ
તાર્કિક હૈ उन्होंने कहा ये बेट था नहीं तर्क के हिसाब से क्योंकि आत्मा का स्वभाव उपयोग आत्मा है उपयोग आत्मा जो है इसीलिए वो दो नहीं हो सकते वहाँ इसलिए जिनवद्र है
त्रण लोग में जाना देखने आवे आप जाने अपने एग्जिट जाने एक एग्जिट जाने होता है नहीं क्या कहते हैं क्या निवास
है
जिनवद्र कहीं आदमवादी है सिद्धसेन दिवाकर तर्कवादी है दोनों में फिर यशो विजय जी ने दोनों का समन्वय जो मैंने अभी कहा ऐसे किया
व्यवहार
दोनों को साथ मिला करके इस दृष्टि से और
આપણે બધું પ્રતિમા બોલીએ છીએ, સમય સમય ની વાત જાણે દેખે છે, એનો અર્થ કે દરેક સમય જાણે દેખે છે. પ્રતિમા એક સમય જાણે એક સમય દેખ્યો નહીં હોતા, પણ સમય સમય ની વાત જાણે દેખે છે.
तो आप ये बात होगी एक तो पूरी. अब आगे बताते हैं कि फिर व्यवहार में की जरूरत क्या है. जब आप ये बात कह रहे हो फिर देखो, अब तक कुनकुन बहुत साफ कहते हैं व्यवहार में की जरूरत है, उसके बिना काम नहीं चलेगा. अभी हम नहीं पहुंचे वहां तक. आपको अगर टेरेस पर जाना है, जाना तो टेरेस पर सीधी की जरूरत है. अरे भी छलन लगाओगे क्या ऊपर से?
This
is indispensable.
It is required.
Unless you go by this staircase, you can't reach the terrace. It is indispensable. Without that, there is no other alternative. That is not. And in heading a jar kuch hai, indispensability of the popular technique of vyavahar. Main kya chahe? Jahan navi सक मनजो अनज भाषम बिना उगाए दुम तह व्यवहारेण बिना परमथु वदेशन मस्तकम. क्या मतलब? जस्ट एज एग्जाम्पल जो दिया है, इतना सचोट एग्जाम्पल, स्ट्राइकिंग एग्जाम्पल. क्या कहते हैं? जस्ट एज a non-aryan, an aryan, cannot be instructed or communicated in any other language except his own language, that is non-aryan language. Similarly, without resorting to popular adaptation or a much to वदेशम असक्तम, ट्रांसेंडेंटल अल्टीमेट ट्रूथ कैन नॉट बी कम्युनिकेटेड. दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल गिवन. वेदर इट इज एक्सप्लेन हियर, नो नो नो, बट आई समवेयर रेड दैट द पीपल फ्रॉम इंडिया, they used to have trading with Anarya desh, where this non-Aryan people stay. They will take all the commodities from India in the ship, sea ship, through ocean. They will travel there, and then they will have the business there. Then it is example is given how they will then communicate, and they will put their commodities, this. And they don't know their language, When they express only through showing this thing, give, this you give,
barter.
Barter. Like this. So non-Aryan and Aryan, they communicate such thing. The same language, when the Keval Jnani wants to communicate the transcendental experience with these Anarya people, how can he give him in Aryan language?
Oh my goodness, man. Ekdam clarity thi. Barabar chhe. Eno je view chhe, which is a very limited view, the one who is sitting beyond, besides him. Ava ene shu khai sakne. Very limited.
This verse justifies the necessity of the expression of the transcendental truth into non-scientific or popular language and method. The same thing happened with Einstein. You know, Einstein was asked, what is your relativity theory? You say space is relative, time is relative. It is absurd. In the beginning, many scientists say it is absurd.
Agree with
that. It is idiot's idea. They criticize like this. And everybody asked, what is it? What is relativity?
But that's what I was saying. કે વૃદ્ધા તે બેસો 5 કલાક બતાવે લાગે કે છ કલાક થઈ ગયા અને એક લેડી હાથે બે હતું છ કલાક લાગે તો ને પાંચ કલાક
To actual mathematical explanation of Einstein's relativity theory, only a few hundred people know what is it actually. Because it is mathematical. How the time and space are relative, the equation, how the time synchronizes, gets contracted, contraction of time, and how the space contracted. That is completely mathematical expression. It is not a substantive language. You can't explain. But for people, they have to explain it. So they make it vyavahar and simple, that this like this. The same thing.
Theory of relativity.
That is the theory of relativity. I have a simple example.
Now, then have a notation here. This verse justifies the necessity of the expression of the transcendental truth into non-scientific or popular language and method. Although the ultimate aim of the author is to get behind or transcend mere appearances and reveal the real, the absolute character of the self, which is called paramartha, which lies behind them, it is impossible to communicate with naive or unenlightened people. People are naive, they are unenlightened, and you want to communicate that truth to them. Unless the technique of communication is suitably adapted and made understandable by them. In real life, one had to communicate with strange people. It is necessary to somehow adapt the medium of communication and make it intelligible to them, expressing one's views in a manner which is beyond the comprehension of the audience serves no useful purpose. If we will talk in transcendental language, it will be of no use, we will not understand. You don't know English and I am going speaking English with you.
It is
just like Vyas Adibhagavat. While it is admitted that vyavahar by itself leaves all ultimate questions on one side and deals only with the empirical questions, it is indispensable in the treatise in order to make it comprehensible to the primitive and naive aspirants. So, indispensability of vyavahar.
એટલે મારે 35 વચના અતિશય જે કહેવામાં આવ્યા છે જેટલી એમની કેપેસિટી છે આટલી.
સમયસાર
શ્રુત કેવલી, ધ ડેફિનેશન ઓફ શ્રુત કેવલી ઇઝ ગિવન હિયર. ધ ઓથર સેઝ ઓનલી ધેટ સોલ હુ થ્રુ હિઝ ઓન ફેકલ્ટી ઓફ શ્રુત, that is bhavashruta, scripture or verbal knowledge, apprehends by direct experience its this singular pure and perfect self is entitled to be called shruta kevali, that is one who is deemed to be omniscient by virtue of his perfect scriptural knowledge by seers who are illuminators of the entire lok. So here he emphasizes both the things. Shruta Kevali must have the direct experience of the perfect and pure self. That is necessary. In spite of the knowledge, उसके पास ज्ञान है, शुद्ध ज्ञान जो है वो अगाध है उसका, लेकिन इसके साथ शर्त ये है कि शुद्ध ज्ञान के द्वारा उसका अपने आप का, अपनी शुद्ध आत्मा का उसको जो है ज्ञान अनुभव होना चाहिए। सारा शुद्ध ज्ञान कर लिया, मान लीजिए शास्त्र का ज्ञान कर लिया, लेकिन अगर उसने शुद्ध आत्मा के विषय में ज्ञान नहीं किया, उसको नहीं जाना, उस पर ध्यान नहीं लगाया, तो उसका मतलब फिर वो शुद्ध केवल ही कहलाने के लिए लायक
एलिजिबल नहीं।
दैट सोल हु हैज लर्नड स्क्रिप्चरल नॉलेज इन इट्स एंटायरिटी, संपूर्ण श्रुत ज्ञान, संपूर्ण शास्त्र ज्ञान है, इज कॉल्ड व्यवहार श्रुत केवली। बाय द जिनास बिकॉज स्क्रिप्चरल नॉलेज इन इट्स एंटायरिटी, द्रव्य श्रुत ज्ञान इज श्योर प्रिकर्सर ऑफ आत्मा सेल्फ एंड देयरफॉर श्रुत केवली इज क्वालिफाइड टू बी डेजिग्नेटेड एज स्क्रिप्चरल ओमनिशियंट। उसके पास द्रव्य श्रुत ज्ञान जो है, उस द्रव्य श्रुत ज्ञान के साथ जब वो अपने श्रुत ज्ञान के द्वारा एप्रीहेंस डायरेक्ट एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ द सेल्फ, प्योर एंड परफेक्ट सेल्फ, तो वो फिर भाव श्रुत केवली बनती है।